Welcome to Water Wisdom, sponsored by waterfilters.net. I'm your host, Aquaman, and today we're focusing on whole house filtration. Now, I want to show you the basics of a system and then go over some of the important highlights when changing the filters in your whole house filtration system. Over here, you can see we have a complete system arrayed over here. And we've done a good job preparing this system and doing everything the right way. This is how your system should look if you install it yourself or if you have your plumber do it. What we have over here, for starters, we have a shutoff valve before the entire system. This is crucial. You've got to have a way to shut the water off before it enters the system. Then we have a pressure gauge before and after each of the filter housings. You can see this. This is the way that you can recognize pressure drop in your system. You have to have the pre and the post pressure gauges in order to recognize pressure drop, which is going to give you a clue when you need to change your cartridges. Over here we have stage one, the sediment filter. Then we have the softener, which we're not really going to deal with right now. And then we go into the carbon block and then into a UV system, which we'll cover more in a later session. And then also down here we have a reverse osmosis system. This is a GE Merlin, the highest quality residential RO system available today. Now, we want to talk about some of the issues that go into changing your cartridges. Over here you have your sediment cartridge. We're going to change that out for this right here. This is a 20 micron pleated cellulose sediment cartridge. It's pleated. It's going to remind you a lot of an air filter. It's going to have a very high loading capacity. This cartridge isn't going to be appropriate for well water, but for our situation here, municipal water, we're okay with that because we're not worried about bacteria eating this filter media. Then we have the carbon block. We're using an EP20BB, which is a 5 micron carbon block, and that's going to go into this second filter housing. Alright, so when you want to begin changing the cartridges, the first step is to shut off the water pressure before the system. We've got a shutoff valve in the proper place. Shut off the water with that valve. Now we need to release the pressure from the system. This can be done a couple of ways. One is by pressing the red pressure release button on top of each of the filter housings. That's going to release pressure, but better to release pressure from one of the major taps, and that's the kitchen tap or the bathroom tap, whatever. You got to get that water pressure out. We've done that already significantly. Then also, we have planned ahead and placed shutoff valves after the system also. This is a great idea, worth the time and the money, because now I'm stopping all the water in the house from backflowing and coming out of the cap of the filter housing when I remove the sump. Now I don't have to worry about that. I got the water on the back side of the system shut off, on the front side of the system shut off. We're good to go. I've got my SW4 spanner wrench, and I'm going to remove the filter housing. Righty tighty, lefty loosey, just like every screw that you've ever used in your life. Righty tighty, lefty loosey, and that's all we need. Don't need the wrench anymore. And now I want to hang on tight because it's heavy. It's got the cartridge plus a lot of water in it. Unscrew filter sump from the cap, and there we have it, nice and wet. Good thing I had my bucket handy. Now, here is why we have water filters. Look at that nasty gunk on this cartridge. And compare this to a brand new, unused cartridge like this. This is what this thing looked like when it was new. Sparkling white spun polypropylene, 5 micron, or maybe this was a 1 micron, not absolutely sure, but you get the idea, sediment filter. And now it's loaded with this nasty crud. Aren't you glad that you weren't drinking that or bathing in it? Okay, so now we're going to put the new cartridge in. Here we have our our pleated cellulose 20 micron cartridge. Pull it out of its plastic wrapper. And place it into the sump. press it and seat it onto the little post that's in the bottom of the sump. And now we're going to do what everyone should always do. We're going to inspect our O-ring for dings, abrasions, flat spots, whatever the case may be. Looks like it's in good shape. I've got a handy dandy towel right here. I'm going to clean out the groove that the O-ring sits in. And then I'm going to take food grade silicone grease available on waterfilters.net. This is the 5 ounce tube. I'm going to take a little bit of that food grade silicone grease and I'm going to lubricate this O-ring thoroughly. Be generous with the lubricant. You won't regret it. Resist the temptation to use any other lubricant. Your O-ring will bloat up like the Hindenburg and you will spring a leak. That would be bad. I'm also going to take a little more of this food grade grease and I'm going to put it in the groove on the sump. Make sure I have a nice layer of that grease. Now we'll reseat the O-ring into the groove. And I'm also not done with the grease. I'm going to take another generous glob and I'm going to lubricate the threads all the way around the sump. This is going to make your life a lot easier when you go to change filter cartridges. It's going to make it easier for the sump to screw on and for it to unscrew. You saw how easy mine came off? That's because we lubed it properly when we did it the first time. If you don't do that, you'll be over there with three guys in muscle shirts cranking on that thing, wishing it would come off. You don't want to be that guy. Use the food grade silicone grease. I'm also going to take another glob. Don't you love my terminology? Another glob. And I'm going to lubricate the threads up in here in the cap. Just going to get a generous dose of that grease up in here on these threads. All right, looking good. Now we'll reattach the sump. Right and tidy. There we go. Got it started. Now there's a good trick that can be used that I didn't show you when I did this. I just thought of it just now. What you can do before you move this thing off, before you start this process, you can take a piece of masking tape and set it across both the black cap and the sump and mark it, or put one piece of tape here and one piece of tape here and mark it with a black marker. That way you know how far it needs to tighten to be in the same position as it was when you started the process. That way you know you've turned it far enough when you're resealing it. I didn't do that, but we're pretty confident. We know what we're doing around here, so we're gonna get it okay. Tighten it down. Now, you notice I'm not using the wrench right now. Don't use this for tightening. You'll smash the O-ring down, make flat spots, and it'll spring a leak on you. Hand tight only, nicely, firmly hand tight, and we're good to go. That right there is the basics of changing a filter cartridge from a filter housing. And it's going to be the same process for the carbon block or really any other size of filter housing. You might have a 10 inch, you might have the smaller, narrower ones. It's the same basic process. I'm Aquaman, and this is Water Wisdom, sponsored by waterfilters.net.